Well, I remember first drawing it and getting it in the mail, and I gave my dad a call, and I knew it was a big deal. Did not realize just how big of a deal. I remember about 5 minutes after I called my dad, I had about 15 different calls from all kinds of friends and family, just ecstatic about this hunt. Kept telling me just how lucky of a guy I was. And, it took a little while to set in. And then I realized, well, this is serious. I gotta get ready for it. You know, started hiking more, got a personal trainer at the gym, spent about 4 or 5 days a week out at the gun range. Can't tell you how much ammo I shot through. I mean, my bank account was zero.
What caliber gun did you use on this?
Using my 270 Remington, had a nice little Leopold scope on it. I started off shooting the Remington Core Locks, the 130 grains. Did pretty well, getting pretty comfortable at 200-300 yards. Then I switched over to the Federal Premium, the Nosler brand. So I ended up coming out here with, I think, the Federal Premium Barnes, which, as we can see, did the job just fine. I remember first getting up on that hill, it was nothing like I expected it. That is a fact. I mean, I remember thinking it felt like the rubble of a city, you know, if something was just completely torn down, everything's just rock everywhere. I mean, nothing's very stable. Looks about one of the worst places you'd ever want to be stranded. The hikes weren't too bad. I was in pretty good shape. My boots gave me a little bit of trouble. Definitely that last hike there, packing this bad boy out, that took a beating on me. I'm in recovery mode right now. But I remember one of the biggest things about the terrain was when we were supposed to sneak up on these guys. And so I'm here trying to be as stealthy as I can. Well, if you've ever hiked in this scenery, I mean, it's just walking on that flagstone, you might as well just be treading through about a foot of glass. There's no such thing as being quiet. They're just being less noisy.
Yeah. Absolutely.
We first saw this ram here about a week ago, and we had a little bit of problems with some weather and stuff. It wasn't cooperative, and then we finally got on him yesterday, and we got the final stock going. And tell us a little bit about that.
The stock. Oh well, I remember the first day we left off seeing this guy and a little younger ram. Not too bad, but we definitely we noticed this guy right off the bat, how symmetrical he was, and so he was the one we were looking at. And saw him. I think we were watching him from about 2 o'clock to, I'd say, about 4. Didn't get too good of a view on him. We were fighting the clouds most of the time, so that was kind of a pain. But I caught a couple glimpses of him, knew that he was definitely a nice ram, something to keep my eye out for. So we went back to camp. Remember going out the next day, and then we saw a group of probably, must have been about 7 or 8 of them, if I remember right. One took off, and we were left with about 7. 5 of which were all, great rams. This guy was he may not have been the thickest for sure, but he was without a doubt the prettiest, the most symmetrical, and we knew that this was probably the one to be keeping an eye out for. From there, we snuck back around the ridge line. We had a couple guys get in position, keeping their eyes out for him. Remember sneaking around and going over some pretty rough terrain. I mean, there were a couple times where I got a little skittish going down some of those cliffs, man, because you took a step and all of a sudden you're sliding on a rock for a couple feet. Ooh, it was something else. But oh man, I remember putting the stock on him, slowly sneaking up, being very cautious. And this guy was actually, we didn't even see him for the first little bit. We had our eyes on looked a little, not nearly as long, but he had a really, really well put together base. Our first target was. We were waiting for him to stand up as he was bedding down. We were probably watching them for about 15, 20 minutes, I'd say. And then this bad boy, along with a couple other nice little rams, came walking up from the canyon a little farther down. And I remember the minute I saw this guy, I was like, that is what I want to take. I knew that. So we were watching him, and he was always guarded by one of those little guys. Like, they knew we were trying to get him. So some of the littler rams would be walking into him, nudging him, kind of knocking horns with him a little bit. So I kept my scope on him, and I remember I must have been looking through that scope for a good 10 minutes straight, just never taking my eyes off this guy. Arms started getting a little shaky, eye was twitching a little bit, and just waiting. And I remember one little ram was just knocking up against him, and then that final knock, he just kind of backed off. This guy moved to the side, gave me a perfect shot of his shoulder, and before my guy next to me could finish saying, take him, shot, and he was down. It was a good, definitely one of the most intense experiences I've ever had. I don't think I've ever been more just nerve-rattled and happy at the same time. I mean, the minute I saw him hit the ground, I was walking on sunshine, absolutely.
And that's a beautiful ram. What kind of measurements are on him? What kind of score is that?
He came out to, he was 39 inches long, both even. I think they the only maybe eighth of an inch off from each tip. And then he's 26 wide. His bases are outstanding, just 16 and about an eighth, 2/8. And just, I mean, a phenomenal ran. I think he came out to a total score of 183, which is, I mean, that is just, I have nothing to complain with there. I'm looking forward to maybe even this April getting Ram of the Year, depending on how these next couple months play out.
Well, congratulations, Cale. That's a heck of a ram. That's a really nice ram.
How long a shot did you have to make? How far was it?
It was only 170 shot, which was perfect, because right before I came out here, I was practicing about 200, and each one was right on the money, right where I needed it to be.
It was 170, but it was a pretty steep angle.
It was. I mean, heck, I shot him in the shoulder, and it came out in the middle of his chest. Heck, walking away with this thing, that was the main goal, though. And it's intact and just looking beautiful.
Yeah, what about the pack out of your, how's your feet doing?
Yeah, I figured I'd have to answer that. It was horrible. I have got to thank Frank at Club 24 in San Luis Obispo. That guy whipped me into shape and it paid off. Walking up that, after that first day, I knew my boots weren't fitted for my feet perfectly, and I had a couple little rashes, and I knew right when we dropped him, I mean, my feet were already kind of hurting, but, adrenaline was going. Throw this guy, and add an extra about 50 pounds to my pack, started hiking him out, and I remember I had to get used to his weight because those horns would start sliding, and I'd go with him. So trying to step down those hills.
Better than a 10-mile hike.
Right? Well, it's about 10 miles later, we finally make it to the truck. And this guy's beat my legs to death. This thing right here was digging in my back for those whole 10 miles. Got a nice little love mark on my back from that. And then the funniest thing about that, though, was just when I finally took the pack off, I fell down, got back up, and I kept wanting to lean forward as I walked because I was compensating for the weight still. Had to get my bearings, took me a couple minutes, but I know for a fact that after that hike, after the work I've put in for this beauty, I will never forget this hunt. It's not only a remarkable, just amazing adventure, it is a life changer, that's a fact. I'm so happy right now. I'm all smiles.
Yeah, I was just glad to be part of the experience, man. That was it. It was cool to watch. I enjoyed it. I got to see the whole thing go down. I could see the hunters. I could see the sheep. And it was just a cool thing to be a part of. I'm glad to be a part of it. And I'm happy for Caleb, man. He's a lucky man.
Pretty excited for him. He's family to me. And it's a cool deal. Sharing a hunt like that with family, let alone just any other client, is a pretty awesome thing. And having Bob, Caleb's dad, around too was awesome.
Everybody did a fantastic job. We've got a great crew of guys here, and Matt had the opportunity, did a great job. I'm pretty proud of him. Grover here, I tell you, our cook is second to none.
And sure.
A lot of good food, good fellowship, just a great crew. And glad to work with all of them there and keep them happy with all my food there.
Got the wood burner going and hors d'oeuvres and good food. Doesn't get any better than that, guys.
About as good as it gets.
Yeah.
Thank you guys all, partner.
Thank
Great
you.
Job, man. Thank you.
It's an amazing thing to happen. He got into great shape. He lost a bunch of weight. He worked hard. He fired that rifle until he knew exactly what it was doing. He prepared. He was ready. One shot. He had great outfitting group. Great bunch of guys that were working with him. It was amazing. Everything was exactly the way you would want it to be. No matter what, that's exactly what you want it to be.